Welcome to Minority Report, and I'm your host, Lachelle Smith. Minority Report is a video blog on YouTube celebrating Black-owned businesses. And on this episode of Minority Report, I'm here to give you the person who is going to help you make sure your finances are in order for your business. I have with me Falashade, the accountant. Thank you so much for being a guest on my platform. How you doing, girl?
Lovely. Now, thank you so much for having me.
You're welcome. Outside
of the storms here in Maryland, I am just so excited to be here with you tonight.
It's storming here in PA too, and it's just, and it's off and on. That's the problem. It's not like, it just keeps being these like repetitive downpours. I'm like, what in the world is going on? It's like 1 minute I look outside, it's sunny. I look outside again, it's pouring down, it's pitch black and pouring down rain. So we got a lot going on, but that's all right. We made it here, made it through the technical difficulties, and now we can really get into the meat of this interview. So, well, first I want to ask you, you know, with everything that's been going on with the stay-at-home order and the pandemic, you know, a lot of Black-owned businesses are suffering. What type of, you know, advice are you giving to those that you consult with about making sure that they're still maintaining their books? You know, how are they going about applying for funding and grants, or if you know what I mean, if they are eligible for them? Like, what type of business accounting and finance advice are you giving out in this season?
Oh, you know what? That is an amazing question. So right now in this season, I am given a variety of advice, from loan advice, accounting, tax, but then to also cuss, like just standard business advice. So like right now during this tough time, number one thing that we definitely need to do is beef up our level of customer service. Since there's just so much supply right now in so many different areas that most African-American businesses are located in or operate in terms of the industry and the type of businesses that we operate, there's just so much competition. So with amazing customer service right now, that will allow you to stand apart. So focus heavily on customer services so you can focus on retaining the client and hopefully, girl, you know, they
keep that money coming in,
right? Tell a friend now. One thing that you definitely need to do. The second thing that I'm telling them is that for all of the small businesses that do have their businesses in order, they have their EIN, they have their businesses registered, or if they don't have an EIN or they have their business registered, but they do have the paperwork to back up their independent contractors, I am advising them if they have a viable business to apply for funding. Pick up high gear and really focus on building a business. And I tell those type of customers, clients, to go for the funding. The clients that are lackadaisical, you know, very comfortable in a 9-to-5, I did not advise them to apply for the funding because, you know, they may get comfortable with the money sitting there, look, girl, and then never move forward. But if you know you had your business registered prior to February 15th, 2020, and you're eligible to apply, especially if your business was profitable in some form or fashion. So either you had employees and you can qualify for the EP, or you had a decent revenue and you can qualify for the EIDL. So I just recommend, especially African-American businesses right now, to apply for funding because this is really our first opportunity to get easy access to funding. And like of opportunity at this low interest rate, girl, we may never get this ever again in our lifetime. And so, like, there's no redlining. Look, there's none of that stuff that we face. None of the discrimination when it comes down to the lending right now. And it's just that, honestly, you do have to have some type of credit.
Right. Now, I did notice that. I mean, I just applied myself for the EIDL last night. And I was just amazed at how simple the process was. It was like 6 questions. And if you have access to, you know, your EIN, if you have your bank account information readily available, which I always do, I information saved on my phone. I got stuff written on stickies right here where my workstation is, I was just like done. It was like 3 minutes, literally. So, I mean, if you are in business and you haven't been out here chasing this funding, I have an accountant here who's telling you, you better go get it. Better go get it. I mean, it's cool to see, you know, these memes and everything, and we want to fall into the trap of absorbing all the negative comments, you know, all the people who aren't getting the funding, all the people who got the funding and didn't deserve the funding. Don't let that deter you. Go on ahead and get it. Now, with the customers that you, well, the clients that you have as an accountant, explain to my followers exactly, like, who's your ideal customer? Because, and I'm asking this question because, first of all, as a sole proprietorship, we tend to go it alone. And if there's anything that I can delegate, for me, it's going to be the math and the numbers. Now, I'm really good at keeping my receipts, and I'm really good at, you know, filing my taxes quarterly. However, you know, I know that that's something that I'm not the greatest at. So, you know, who's like your ideal customer? If anybody out there is like me, this is the part you definitely going to want to lean in for.
Yeah, so my ideal customer is the startup to mid-size, well, not really mid-size, the startup to small business that basically want to be successful but have no idea as to what really to do. Mm-hmm. They haven't been trained. They're the technician in their businesses, so that means they know everything about the industry, the ins and outs, everything. But when it comes to having a business acumen or having a business background, they lack that. Mm-hmm. When it comes to being able to do their own bookkeeping and stuff, they're unable to do so because of their lack of expertise or knowledge in that area. And then last but not least, they need that push and that accountability to keep them going and to be able to push them to the greatness that they are. Right. And so ideal client is that individual that's right there in the middle, that have gotten their feet wet, mm-hmm. that have made some coins, made some money, but haven't been able to get to 50,000, haven't been able to get to 100,000, mm-hmm. haven't been able to get to $500,000.
Right.
Ideal client. So I use the accounting and my business acumen and my mm-hmm. skill set to be able to build businesses to really give them the extra resources, the knowledge, and the, like, the coaching that they need to grow.
So now you're mentioning coaching as well as accounting. So I try to tell people, like, listen, if you just think of your business as a bucket, right? If your bucket has a hole in it, you don't know where that money is going. You have no idea. You don't know if you're overextending yourself just on credit. You don't know if you have too much product. You don't know if you don't necessarily have an accountant, but you also provide coaching services. So what I really want you to do is break down, you know, you have your ideal client that mid-range hasn't quite been able to, you know, make it over the hurdle as far as how much money they're bringing in, but then break down the number and the different types of services that you offer. Cause I know you do bookkeeping and things like that, but I want you to really let everyone know this is exactly what Felasha Day, the accountant, provides.
Yeah, so no, that's the unique part about my services, because it's all encompassing. So my monthly bookkeeping services, okay, it encompasses your accounting. So I do your bookkeeping behind the scenes. It encompasses your monthly sessions with me when we talk about your numbers. And during those sessions, I coach them as well. So let me give you an example of what it looked like. So this month, we are pulling and going over all of the data from January up into the month of May, mm-hmm. In regards to that. So right now, I'm looking at my clients' revenue, their bottom line expenses, and I'm connecting the dots to what's on their P&L to what mm-hmm. actions or what they're performing virtually or in their businesses. Mm-hmm. So I use their results, which is the accounting, their results to see what's working, what's not working, and what they are doing.
Right.
With holding the CEO or the owner accountable, then nothing gets done.
Right.
Out the CEO and the owner mm-hmm. have strong business acumen, mm-hmm. then they will never be able to scale and grow and profit. So I found when I first started to niche down in my company that if I didn't coach them, then they wouldn't even know what to do with the numbers.
Right.
They wouldn't even know what to do with the numbers. Mm-hmm. So you tell somebody slash, you know, expenses, but that's the basis of accounting.
Right.
you start to have your bookkeeping done in a certain manner, you start to see what products aren't working, what services aren't working, where you're overspending at, what margins do you have. And at that point, that's where having the business knowledge come into how to negotiate, mm-hmm. how to create proposals, how to fish, mm-hmm. how to get money. Mm-hmm. So how do we take the guesswork out of building your business? Mm-hmm. The only thing my clients need to do is focus on their passion, their business, and doing exactly what they need to do. And that encompasses us brainstorming on the next marketing campaign they may do, because mm-hmm. I'm a businesswoman. I'm not right. just an accountant. I have a multiple six-figure company. And I've been able to do that with zero investment, zero help. So with that being said, I use that and all my trials and tribulations and being behind the scenes of so many different small businesses, hundreds mm-hmm. of small businesses, that it's been innate that I use my business skill set, money-making attributes, mm-hmm. and my numbers to help them scale and grow. So let me give you an example. One of my hairstylists came to me December 2018, December 5th. She said, Flashiday, I'm not ready to move forward. I'm not sure this and that. Should let me just wait until January, because I'm, you know, you saying start now. It's going to be a month to onboard. So look, and when she came to me, she was making $53,000. This was December 5th, 2018. December 5th, 2019, she made $115,000. And it's only off of all of the strategy that I advised her to do. So, for example, I beefed up her sales. I asked her, okay, well, what you doing with your sales? How are you bringing in clients? What you got going on? So, she'll mm-hmm. tell me, and I'll need this. And I'll be like, okay, all righty. So, since you said your money goal is to make $100,000, let's go ahead on and focus on the next 2 weeks. Let's do X, Y, Z. Mm-hmm. And bring me the results back. Once you bring the results back, oh, my gosh, for last day, so X, Y, Z client got on my books. I was able to sell this product. I was able mm-hmm. to do this. Momentum keep going. And then
right. Of course, you start seeing money coming in. Yeah, that's motivation right there. Okay, she's giving me good advice. Let me keep, you know, applying what it is that she's telling me to do, because I want to see these coins. I got a goal and I'm trying to get there. So yeah, now for those clients who are, I want to call them micromanagers. I want to say those clients who, you know, they pretty much have their accounting down, right? But they still need, you know, a little help here and there. Do you provide kind of like a la carte type services for them, where they can kind of piecemeal your abilities and your skill set? Do you have that capability?
Yes. So if a client came to me and they were already having their books in order, they can have me review their bookkeeping and then pay me to clean it up. Okay. Mm-hmm. So it will be much more effective if that person is able to do it on their own correctly, to have me clean it, and it's, you know, not a lot of work.
Right.
But if the books aren't in order and they've been doing it, it's going to cost just as much as having me do it the right way.
The right way.
Yeah. So wow. It just off of where they are once I review the books, mm-hmm. See if everything been properly reconciled, and to see if everything, have all of the just and entries have been made, make sure there's no negative accounts on the balance sheet, all of the various things that are very important when it comes to presenting your numbers to anybody, especially external parties. But yes, they can acquire the services. So within my firm, we offer a la carte services. So you'll have your bookkeeping training. So if you don't want to pay anyone to do it, you can pay me to train you, mm-hmm. and I can train you on how to do it. Now, this is not accounting training, you right. know, on how to do everything, but still where you might make some mistakes and still need me to clean up some things, right. but you know how to operate it, function it, and do the you know, the basics mm-hmm. and stuff like that. So I have that. And then I have my bookkeeping cleanup, where they've messed up things, don't know where to go. Then I have my monthly bookkeeping services, and that is on a three-tier level as well, depending on where the client is. Mm-hmm. So if the client needs bookkeeping, but they have one account, two or three bank accounts, that's mm-hmm. tier one. They have more accounts, tier two. And if they have more accounts and then payroll and everything else, then that's tier three. And then the tax services are independent, but are part of tier two and tier three. Bookkeeping. Yeah.
Okay.
Tier one still have to make the investment to, because they're, you know, the service is much mm-hmm. more inexpensive. and everything else. But no, I basically try to find a way to get all businesses to understand the importance of their accounting. Mm-hmm. Whether we like it or not, we have to do it some way, somehow. So by providing the different options, mm-hmm. I think it allows people to choose what best fits their needs. But I'm going to be really, really honest with you. Even the most detailed people that I've seen do their books still aren't doing them right.
Right. Okay.
And this is 16 years, thousands and thousands of bookkeeping clients and people that had me review their books, and they still do not get it. It still requires a very sound accounting background. So what I found is if I can alleviate that from them and they can focus on it, then they can make triple the amount of money and it have the best lifestyle with them trying to shamble and, you know, do all the bookkeeping themselves when they can just eat and be over the paperwork, girl, and then look.
And be done. And go do and go have a drink somewhere.
Meetings, and then we'll walk over the numbers and see what's happening, and then you can go from there. I think what I realized, honestly, is that it's great that we have Google, but just allow the experts to do what the experts are required to do. Right. I will never be able to do what you're doing. Nope. If any of my clients said they want to do it, I'm going to be like, hey, are you teaching a class? If I want to put on my own magazine to help my clients, I'll come to you.
Right.
I'm going to try to learn everything
about your business. Right.
Exactly.
I get it. That absolutely makes sense. Like, once your business grows to a certain scale, you're going to have to delegate certain things. And just like you said, for the most part, your clients are subject matter experts, or, you know, they're professionals in whatever their field is. I don't care if they selling cars, selling bundles, you know, selling their own services, ebooks, whatever. After you get to a certain point, you're going to have to ask people. Just like, you know, you're so quick to hire a business coach, you're so quick to hire somebody to manage your social media, please strongly consider hiring somebody to do your book so that you make sure you're paying yourself accurately, you're investing into your business accurately, you're not losing any sales, not losing any customers, paying your taxes on time, all of that. Those are the benefits of working with someone like Felicidae. I'm going to strongly recommend that you get with her. I have one more question. Do you have like self-start type of materials? Because I know some people are going to watch this and they're still going to walk away saying, nope, I can do it. I got QuickBooks. I'm good. And then them is the people we're going to have to pray for later. Because they'll come to you in a crisis when they should have just been working with you from the very beginning. So do you have like any type of like content materials or kind of, you know, marketing materials for somebody who's still on the fence, who even after they've heard this, they're still like, I think I got this. I've been doing this long enough. Yeah. Do you have any type of materials for people like that to say, you know what I mean, where you can kind of point out there's some things that you might be missing that an accountant like myself is going to catch for you?
Oh, a lot of them. So a lot of small businesses are overstating their revenues. And they don't even know it simply because their books aren't done and all they're doing is go. And so let me just be honest with everybody here. QuickBooks does not do it automated for you. Now, if you pay the QuickBooks for their new service, okay, that's something different. But just having QuickBooks, because I'm starting to hear people say that, oh, I got QuickBooks, I'm okay. That is not accounting and that is not bookkeeping. QuickBooks is the software and it doesn't do it for you. Even if I use the rules and try to do it, it doesn't work.
Right.
None of them have to have an accounting knowledge. So what I want an individual to understand that you can come and take my course, because I do have like a self-start course that walks you through how to set up your QuickBooks, how to do everything. You can purchase that program, but what still happens is the underlying thing. I am the expert and you aren't. So you have to take a few extra little accounting courses to know some things about debits and credits and all of those things before you really get it. Before we get it. Like the QuickBooks training, right? Like I have my staff do the QuickBooks training, girl. Even after 3 years of doing QuickBooks training, they still don't got the base because they don't have degrees in accounting. Mm-hmm. So they don't understand the correlation between certain transactions. And it,
I understand. I guess why I'm so, I want to say passionate about it, but why I want to just put more emphasis on your services and your business is because I don't want to see anybody lose a dime. You know, I don't want, because your bucket has a hole in it, you know, that you're missing out on opportunities to make more money, or you're selling a product that, you know, you might not want to invest in, something you might have to revamp, or you're not selling it for enough. I don't want anyone to experience that. And that's why I just want to put so much emphasis, you know, on what it is that you do and what it is that you offer. There is nothing wrong with saying, yeah, I'm an expert in shea butter, but I'm not an expert at these Excel spreadsheets. I ain't got it. I mean, it's okay. And when you don't have that skill set, it is best for you to hire and invest in a professional. And that is what Felashide the Accountant is. So now I just want you to tell everyone exactly where they can find you, where they can find you online, how they can connect with you so that they can, you know, bask in all of your accounting glory, hon.
So you can follow me on all things social media, Felashide, FOLASADE, the Accountant. Mm-hmm. Also go to bit.ly/Felashide leads with a capital F and a capital L. And there you can join my email list. You can even see some of my clients' testimonials about how I've helped them. And you can get kind of a feel of how working with me may be and figure out what your needs are by going there as well. So I look forward to it. You guys checking out my page and hopefully sending me a message about you are trying to get your stuff in order, especially during this tough time.
Yes. I mean, I hate to laugh, but it's just like right now you can either look at this pandemic, because that's basically what we're in. You can look at this situation right now and you can either be in distress or you can try to make the best of it. And I want people to seize this opportunity to make as much money as possible. And I'm not just talking about, you know, money grabs. I'm not talking about putting out journals that's plagiarized. We ain't finna do that. I'm talking about investing wisely into your business, investing in, you know, take, if this is a time where you take a break and you just learn how to do stuff, sit with Felashide and learn how to do QuickBooks, go back and take some graphic design classes, go back and, you know, revisit that coach or that mentor you haven't talked to in 6 months because you're so busy trying to be booked and busy. This is that time where you can get yourself in order and get your money right. I definitely want you to connect with Felashide, the Accountant. I'm going to keep saying it till y'all get it. I want you to connect with her as soon as possible. Felashide, thank you so much for being a guest on my platform. This conversation has been awesome. If you've watched this and you've got some jewels, or you've ready, you know, you feel convicted, like I need to take that leap and get somebody to look at my books, This video has definitely been for you. Please give me a great big thumbs up. Do not forget to like, share, comment, and subscribe to my YouTube channel. And I will check you guys out next time. Thanks for tuning in.